So I have, you know, really big, I guess, beef when it comes to private equity owns big corporate PT companies. And, you know, I'll just tell you guys a little bit story. I think some of you can relate to this. So I used to work for a bigger PT companies that's owned by a big corporate guy, a big money guy. And, you know, like sitting at the CEO, and then the CEO, the CFO, all those guys are more PTs, right? So essentially the PTs are working for the money guy. And during this time, it was a 25-year anniversary of that company. And there's a contest of, hey, how do we come up with the best slogan that represent what the company does? Whoever come up with the best slogan get a free trip to this resort for a weekend that you can bring your family. So everyone in this PT company was so excited.
Oh, I have a bad feeling about this.
A couple of my coworkers come up with a really good slogan. I was like, oh man, this is great, this and that. So by the time the contest ended, right, we were all excited to see like who won, who get to go away. Turned out none of us won. What had happened was the guy who was the CEO of this company, the money guy, who was very disconnected to healthcare, does not believe in what we do, just want to return on money, said, you know what? The slogan I'm going to come up with is going to be 25 years of rubbing you the right way. So as a PT, I found that extremely offensive because it's not what we do. We're not a massage parlor. We're not a massage therapist. That's not what we do. We don't rub people. That's like literally the most low level thinking you can say to describe a PT. And this individual owns a PT company. So that was the biggest thing. I was like, oh my God, they don't even see value. They don't believe in what we do at all. They're just using us to get return on investment. So this goes to my second point, is that most of these corporate PT owns company, this big conglomerate, are backed by private equity firms. These are investment firms that park their money within this company. So that way, the goal is to get 8 to 10% return long-term on their money, right?
First Galactic Empire.
Ever since the pandemic, you see this more. You can go, whatever town you're in, whatever city you're in, go drive around downtown, you're gonna see more corporate-owned PT clinic popping up. Reason being is that it's a very safe investment. These people know that no matter what, with the pandemic, we're allowed to stay open. So what they're gonna do is like, you know what? This business is actually pandemic proof. Why don't we invest more? Why don't we grow more, right? So that's all they're looking to do is just park their money, grow it, recruit people to work for it, get a good return. So when everyone's complaining about like low insurance reimbursement rate, who do you think is driving it down, right? When people think about like inflation when it comes to employee salary, who do you think is driving it up? It's all these big players in the game, right? So the problem with the PT profession really all come from all this big corporate company that are taking money from people who do not believe in what we do. So therefore we cannot create changes. You know, we need to find a way to take our profession back, right? To the PTs themselves, right? And again, we do it in a small scale, like what I'm doing, what other people are doing by creating a really good clinic that can employ amazing PTs and give them the ability to just treat, give them exceptional care to our patient, right? That's the big part. And this is a trap.
It's a trap.
Huge trap for the new grads PT that are coming out. And this is what I'm seeing right now. They are getting so good at their marketing aspect to recruit people to go into the big corporation. So I'll tell you this, this is a secret, right? I'm a big marketer. I read marketing books. I know how marketing works, right? So what they do to attract new grads is they create what we call a front-end offer, right? This front-end offer, what it does is just attract people to come in to the job ads, to apply, right? The one thing I just saw is like, hey, get you have a chance to enter to win or to make $100,000 as a bonus, right? Apply to qualify. That's a front-end offer, right? That doesn't mean you guys will get it when you apply it. Maybe a select few will get it, and chances are they probably know who's gonna get that money already. They already pre-selected this individual, right? So what they do is like, oh, wait, we're gonna get people in, we're gonna funnel people in, we're gonna trap them with this nice offer and then make them work for us for the next 6 to 12 months. And that's all they're thinking. These people are not thinking about having you work for them long term, right? Because it costs them more money to actually have you work long term, right? When you work for 6 to 12 months, they can make their return extremely quickly because they have no problem getting leads in, right? That means patients just walk off the street, come back in, and then charge them $50. And then they just have to put that 3 or 4 patient on you for an hour and they make their return, right? Your salary would probably cost them $45, right? By seeing one patient, they already make their money back. Seeing the second patient in an hour, they already cover all the overhead expense. Seeing that a 2 patient, that's all profit, right? So that's how they get people in. And the more you guys stay in this kind of company, especially let's say you go to 1 year review, here's what you're gonna get. You're gonna get a 4% raise or a 5% raise at most, right? And the reason why they do that is that, hey, it's a company standard. Who set those standards? They did. That's why they can say it, right? Because big corporations set those standards. And they say, oh, we can only give you 5 because that's the company standard, right? And most people will say, okay, I'll take that or I'll leave. They say, great, if you take it, awesome. Keep doing what you're doing. If you leave, that's fine. We have another CSM seminars coming up or CSM meeting next year where we're just gonna track all these people, use open bar, telling them how to apply to get 100K or student loan forgiveness or X, Y, and Z. All right, and we'll just replace you. It's a number game. It's all a churn, right? And what's gonna happen 10 years down the road, people are gonna start leaving the field. I would encourage you to look at your friend group now and ask how many good PTs are left that you know. And I can tell you right now, within the next 2-3 years, it'll be even lower and lower. All the good PTs are leaving because they care so much about the patient and that they're willing to do whatever it takes to show up, to be there for them, do the notes late at night, because I've been there. But guess what? It's not sustainable. It's not sustainable because the model doesn't allow it to be, because the people who owns this big company do not believe in PT in the first place. That is a huge problem we're gonna have. And my prediction, 2 years from now, you see all the mass layoff in Twitter first, Amazon, Facebook. Guess what? Some PTs right now in the big corporation, they're getting overpaid because there's not enough people. But here's what's gonna happen when reimbursement rates start coming down. Those overpaid PT will get laid off and they will have no other choice, either to take another job, start their own thing, or go to another company, take a pay cut, or just leave the field. So this is my spiel. The biggest fight is always ahead of us. And this is why I always say, like, you know, that's why I started my Facebook group, Badass Clinician, is to start a resistance to fight, you know, these big corporations that are backed by private equity and take back our profession. You know, we all have to start a united movement together. So I hope you guys enjoy my rant today, because this is on the top of my mind. And please connect with me on social media.